In college, did you go and intern under anyone
at any point? In college, I had met this guy, Arjun Janakiram, who happens to be a friend of mine now. He would come in to judge a cultural event, and he started talking about comics. And the next thing you knew, I was talking to him about comics, and he called me over for an internship in to be an illustrator in his firm. And I think I was going there almost every day for about 8 months, six to 8 months. And I learned a lot at the agency. It was called Mattermost Urgent, MMU Communications.
Yeah.
And did quite a bit of interesting work over there, and got a bit of a foundation over there.
And there you did mostly illustration or design?
Mostly illustration. I got to dabble with, Photoshop and Illustrator a little bit more. Although I wasn't very good at it.
Yeah.
I had started to practice stuff by about then.
Okay. And at this point as well, I think you started to do a bit more work in advertising as well, right?
Oh yeah, I think around that time, the same time of this Mattermost Urgent MMU Communications internship, I started doing work for like brands like the Taj, Roshan Lal's. Like they weren't giving me the big work, they were giving me tidbits because I wasn't capable of handling a client end to end.
Yeah, those are pretty big clients.
So I mean, I was working on that, and I think I moved on to my next internship the next year to JWT, where I started to do some real work.
Right.
I felt like it was getting out. I did some work for Ford Endeavor, some small bits of work. Again, it wasn't entrusted fully, but I got to work on stuff over there. And that felt like a little larger agency setup, and I got an understanding of how, you know, the different wheels are in motion within an agency, at least.
Yeah. And what was it like being, I assume MMU was a smaller firm, right?
It was a small outfit.
JWT is huge.
Yeah.
So what was it like being a smaller fish in a much bigger pond in JWT? Was your...
JWT, I was an intern, okay.
So, right, of course.
bottom of the pile kind of thing. No, but people were good. People were very encouraging. I mean, my creative director at that point, Juno Simon, he told me, this shit is not for me.
Okay.
This stuff is not for you, dude. You better come back with some cool work, or I'm not taking you into the agency.
Wow.
So it was like that kind of thing. I was like, damn, this is my life. Put a big chip on my head now to go and do something.
Right.
And at the same time, there were other people like this other guy, Ratish Subramaniam, who was also an art director, creative director in Bangalore.
Mm-hmm.
And, he was very encouraging. There were a lot of people around me who were encouraging. So I think encouragement is like a massive thing in the creative industry. If people keep shooting down your ideas, making you feel really small, it's very hard for you to come up and explain yourself, right?
It motivates you.
If people encourage you and choose the right kind of words to use around you in terms of, like, you know, pushing you forward to come up with a great idea, I think that's a great thing to do.
Yeah, and that would also push you forward when you're being you get negative feedback.
Exactly.
It drives you forward.
It works either way. So if it's a client working with you, you're going to expect them to give you words of encouragement and, you know, in order to problem solve, rather than this work looks pretty bad, man. I don't like it.
Yeah,
I don't like it means it's over there, right? As
correct.
Opposed to something more progressive in terms of like trying to see if there's going to be a positive outcome because of my positive relationship with you. That sort of thing.
Yeah. And okay, so what did you do after college? Once we graduated from Visual Communications, where did you head off?
So after VizCom, I was pretty clueless as to what I was going to do, because the second internship was Juno telling me, dude, you're not made for advertising. So I was actually thinking that advertising is not my cup of tea, and I kind of thought that I wanted to do something else, but I never knew what that was. I knew it had to be something with illustration and design, but I didn't know if I was good enough for it.
Yeah.
And, it was just me and Anek Ahuja, this other friend of mine who's my business partner right now.
Yeah.
Both of us were hanging out a lot, and I was evading interviews, dressing up for interviews from home, going to Anek's house, and we were chilling. And
you were not even going for the interview.
Yeah, we were grabbing beers by the coast. We were doing all that sort of stuff. So I'd pick him up on the bike, take him, we'd go to, go grab a beer, go sit by the East Coast. We'd be talking these big plans, and I don't think I took up most of the interviews because I didn't feel like it was for me. I had some advertising interviews with agencies, but I was a bad guy who didn't turn up for the interviews. So I feel really shitty about that.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
And so eventually, you know, Anik got a job with Design Garage, and I was left like, I don't have anybody to hang out with, nobody to go to the coast with, all that stuff.
Right.
And I started seriously thinking about what to do when this other friend of mine from college, this guy called Abhishek Jayaprakash, also a fantastic designer.
Yeah.
He
yeah.
taught me a lot of stuff as well in design. He told me, dude, you better come and join this company that you'll be perfectly fitted for. The company is called Graph, and where he was working. Graph dealt with design and publishing. And it was run by this by these two people, Bharat Ramaratham and Monica Gurde. They're both photographers. Bharat was an architectural photographer, you must know. And Monica was a fashion photographer. So I joined them, and they were very happy to, you know, take me in with all my mind that wasn't made up. And still they nurtured me, and they got me to where I am right now.
So that sort of put you on the track.
Of course, man.
Moving
I think
forward.
I was very happy when I finally realized that, you know, this is my space.
Yeah.
I just needed to see it. It wasn't pure advertising, it was more of design.
Yeah.
And you know, when you're dealing with the architecture and stuff, it is serious design. It's not like some, let's do design for the heck of it. It's like,
very much.
It's aesthetic stuff. You have to please an architect when you're doing it. So
yeah.
I think it was a great foot to get off on to start with.
And you would have made a lot of contacts as well.
Oh yeah. Worked with some good clients also. Bharat had some really good clients, yeah.
Yeah. So what did you do after after Graph? When you left Graph, you've been there for some time.
Yeah.
You built your contacts, and you're at least now on the right path, right?
I wouldn't say I built my contacts, because a lot of the clients are very far away. So
sure.
Mostly the understanding of, you know, how to deal with clients. I think I got a little bit of experience in terms of an all-round thing as being an art director.
Mm.
You know, like how to work with the photographer, how to work on design, all that stuff.